My name is Emily Brinkman. I am 24 and I am the next soul survivor. So I currently work at a small boutique here in Wisconsin and I manage the social media. So I handle the Instagram, the Facebook, the website. I actually created our own online store and so I manage the online sales for that. And I also am a sales associate in the store itself. And so I wear many hats. I don't have just one title. I have about four or five. And so that helps make me a lot more adaptable and just very versatile. I can do plenty of things and I'm good at a lot of awesome things. So in the game, I most resemble JT. And I love the way that he played the game, especially in his first season, and how he was just insane at challenges, super competitive, always dominated, but at the same time he was loyal to his tribe, and he was able to work within it and find himself at the top of his pack. And even in his second season, how he definitely changed up the game a little bit, I'll probably be doing that as well, and changing it up a little bit, not letting people get too comfortable with where they're sitting. So, my friends like to describe me as funny, quirky, sincere, energetic, competitive. There's a lot of different things that kind of all come into who I am. And ultimately, I like to just define myself as a Christian and as someone who loves Jesus and someone who's not afraid to be honest and real with people. There are two main reasons as to why I think I can win. The first reason is I have just gotten married this past June, so it's been 5.5 months so far, and I know that I'm up for any challenge. As far as going on Survivor, having the financial help for a newly married couple would be huge. So being able to buy a house, maybe an extra car, and being able to start having kids would be amazing. The second reason would be because of my faith. Because I'm a strong, firm believer in Christianity, I just want to be able to test my faith and be able to say, I did this while holding true to my morals, while holding true to my honesty and my integrity, and being able to say, I won because I played the game as best as I could. I think at first people are going to see me as kind of a weak link, someone who would be underestimated, but in actuality I am an intense and fierce competitor, and I think that people are really going to be surprised when they see me out there competing right alongside the macho men and the crazy gymnast ladies and the Olympic swimmers. I'm right up there as far as being able to challenge myself and be physically demanding on my body but yet still come out on top. So I grew up in a large Christian family and my parents were missionaries down to the border of Mexico in California. And just being able to adapt in an all-Hispanic culture was really tough, and being one of four kids at an all-Mexican school was even tougher. And having to adapt in that situation while not even knowing any Spanish and just having to find my way in the school and being able to build relationships, build that community, and find that security and safety will really help me in the game. Growing up in a Christian family was pretty hard. It wasn't until I was about 18 that I actually found my faith and became a Christian myself rather than a family decision. And I actually went to Bible college. I worked at a Bible college. I attend church every weekend, and that's what my life is all about. I love being able to serve and do that. And just trying new things is one of my favorite qualities about me, and so I think that's also going to help in my game as well, with the challenges and the eating crazy food challenge. I am excited for that. I drink a smoothie every morning, maybe not exactly with pig intestines or pig noses or sea slugs and things like that, but hey, I'm excited for the challenge. CBS producers, I am ready to outwit, outplay and outlast everyone to become the sole survivor. So look out.